A world without predators. It sounds like a safer, happier world, but come on, this is science. The only way to really know what would happen would be to do a large-scale experiment that takes a big swath of relatively pristine habitat, divides it up into lots of replicates, removes the top predators from some, and you get it. But luckily, we don't have to go to these great lengths, because someone already ran this experiment for us, accidentally. Hi, I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. The accidental experiment began during the 60s and 70s, when the Venezuelan government built a huge hydroelectric dam on the Caroni River. The dam ended up birthing a brand new lake, which by 1986 had created a bunch of brand new islands of varying sizes, each of which ended up with a more or less representative sampling of local species. Except that all the top predators, like jaguars and harpy eagles, had abandoned or died off on the smaller islands because they didn't give them enough territory to hunt. Scientists quickly realized that the situation was an amazing experimental setup. They could watch what happened on these islands, some of which had predators and some didn't, to document, in real time, what happens when large predators disappear from an ecosystem, something scientists had been debating for years. When scientists checked on the islands in 1994, they found some serious monkey business going on. Literally, the populations of howler monkeys on islands without predators were as much as 50 times denser than those on the large islands, which still had predators. Rodents were crammed onto predator-free islands at 35 times the densities found on islands with predators, and the antics of leafcutter ants were even wilder, especially on the smallest islands, where their populations were 100 times denser than normal. But it wasn't just animals that were affected. Predatorless islands had half the density of tree saplings as the islands that still had predators. And by the year 2000, that is, only 16 years after the experiment began, the predator-free islands had lost 3/4 of their plant species. One scientist described one of the experimental islands as a nearly treeless island buried under an impenetrable tangle of vines. But why did losing the top predator species cause this giant ecological change? Well, with no predators to keep them in check, herbivore populations exploded. Some of those critters quickly nommed their way through their typical food supply, and when that wasn't enough, they started chowing down on stuff they normally passed over, ultimately devouring every plant part they could. Meanwhile, others, like leafcutter ants, carried away plant debris so fast that nothing was left to decompose on the forest floor and replenish the nutrients in the soil that plants need. The few scrappy species that could tolerate these conditions ran wild. In the words of the scientists, removing the top predators unleashed an ecological meltdown. And the Lake Guri Islands are not the only example of such a predator-free catastrophe. Similar meltdowns have happened in places that have lost wolves, sea otters, and even sea stars. So in the end, it turns out that predators aren't preventing that perfect utopia. Instead, they're a huge part of maintaining it. In many parts of the ocean, sharks are those apex predators. But as shark populations crash due to overfishing and climate change, we are just starting to understand how their disappearance could affect all sorts of marine ecosystems. Which is why we are super excited to make this video in partnership with Florida International University, which has been leading much of that research. FIU professor Michael Heidhaus has been studying the role that sharks play in those ecosystems, and the danger that their declines are posing worldwide. It turns out that when shark populations fall, grazers like sea turtles destroy super important seagrasses and kelp forests. But a marine meltdown is not inevitable. Dr. Heidhaus and his colleagues have found that we can protect these key predators by creating protected marine areas and limiting the use of fishing gear known to harm sharks. To learn more about FIU's incredible predator research and all of their other research programs, visit fiu.edu.